And yet,
We know, as human beings, we're not perfect. It's the same for Andrew and Melissa. And yet God has chosen them. That's how special He thinks they are. How special He thinks each one of the couples here is. And all the other couples that He's chosen. That despite our imperfections or whatever, we together can become an image of Him in a very special way. Created in His image, and it's not just about what we look like, but really what we do with our hearts. The way we love, the way we care for each other, the way we forgive each other, the way we go out of our comfort zones and sins for each other. All the different things that are expressions, little expressions of the God who has created us. And the love of God that has this for each one of us. So therefore today, while they make this mission, they make this commitment to each other, and if you listen carefully to the vows, you'll hear actually what they're saying is, I accept you as a gift. That's what they're going to say to each other. It implies that each one is giving themselves as a gift. So they're doing that to each other, but at the same time, they do something much greater than all this. That is to be assigned a mission to each one of us here and to the world. All those that God will put in their path from this day onwards. Because this is a mission of expressing the presence of God to all of us. To know that here is the image of God. And for some of us, that is crazy. But this is what God is saying. That God wants to be known in a particular way. Friends, you have come together in this church so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister and this community, your family and friends. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Andrew and Melissa, have you come here freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
I have.
A bit
louder. I have.
Okay. Did you hear him?
I have.
You have to hear him.
No, don't worry. We're talking to this.
There's enough. Come here. Just. Will you love and honour each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives?
I will. Come on.
I will.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
I will.
I will.
Okay. Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, join your right hands and declare your consent before God and his church. So, Andrew, you're first. I, Andrew.
I, Andrew.
Take you, Melissa.
Take you, Melissa.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honour you.
And honour you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Beautiful. Melissa. I'm Melissa.
I'm Melissa.
Take you, Andrew.
Take you, Andrew.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you.
I will love you.
And honour you.
And honour you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You have declared your consent before the church and the people of God here. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. And what God has joined, men and women must not divide. And we give our consent now, like I was saying, with saying together the Amen. Together?
Amen. Amen.
Okay, now we have the blessing in exchange of rings. Sean?
Leave your mic on so they can hear us. Leave your mic on so they can hear us.
We've got to bless them first. May the Lord bless these rings, which you have given to each, which you give to each other as the sign of your love and fidelity. And we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Melissa?
Take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son. And of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Andrew,
take this ring, sign of my
love, as a sign of my love
and fidelity,
and fidelity
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Andrew and Melissa, I now pronounce you husband and wife.
Thank goodness for that.
And Andrew, you now may kiss your bride.
Ah.
Or your wife.
Get rid of that.
Thank you.
covenant you graciously made with your people, so that by fulfillment of the sacrament of the sign, the mystical marriage of Christ with his church might become manifest in the union of husband and wife among your faithful. Graciously stretch out your right hand over these your servants, Andrew and Melissa. We pray and pour into them, we pray that you pour into their hearts the power of the Holy Spirit. Grant, O Lord, that as they enter upon the sacrament of union, they may share with one another the gifts of your love, and by being for each other a sign of your presence, become one heart and one mind. May they also sustain, O Lord, by their deeds the home that they are forming, and prepare with their children to come to become members of your heavenly household by raising them in the way of the gospel. Graciously crown them with your blessings, your daughter Melissa, so that by being a good wife and mother, she may bring warmth to her home with a love that is pure and adorned with welcoming graciousness. Bestow a heavenly blessing also, O Lord, on Andrew, your servant, that he may be a worthy and good and faithful husband and provident father. Grant, Holy Father, that desiring to approach your table as a couple joined in marriage in your presence, they may one day have the joy of taking part in a great banquet in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And as we come to the end, we bring all our prayer, all these blessings, and we praise them to the Lord in the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Give us the same our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. And we come to conclude with these last blessings. The Lord be with you. May God, eternal Father, keep you one heart.